In this discussion, we are interested to discuss about the properties of central force. So, the properties of center force. Properties of central force. First property, it is a planar force, that is, the motion of the particle is fixed to a plane only. To prove this, we first describe the central force as a function r and 2r cap. Now, r cross f equals r cross of f(r) into r cap. This is the zero, so r cross ddt of md is equal d dt of, since m is constant, r cross v is equal 0. So r cross v is a constant. Say h vector, which is a constant vector. Now r dot of r cross of v, r dot of h, so this is 0 according to vector identity. This becomes v dot r cross r, that is 0. So 0 is equal r dot h, that is r is perpendicular to some constant vector. If we picturize it, then this is the central force motion picture, and the r is always perpendicular to a constant vector h. So the motion remains confined to the fixed plane, this. So it is a planar motion. In central force, the angular momentum remains conserved. In the previous section, we see that r cross f is equal 0. Therefore, r cross ddt of mv, that is momentum, if we represent momentum as speed, dp dt, according to Newton's second law, f is dp dt, is equal 0, which implies R cross P ddt of R cross P is equal 0, since ddt of dr dt cross p is equal 0. So from this line is obtained, since this quantity is 0. Now r cross p is the angular momentum, ddt of l is equal 0. So l is constant, we get l is constant. So in central force problem, the angular momentum remains constant. The third property is the law of area. that is the aerial velocity of the particle moving under central force is constant. Now, what is aerial vector? The area swept out by the radius at equal intervals of time is equal. This means that the aerial velocity of a particle is constant. Aerial velocity is the area swept out by the radius at a interval of time. This is represented by dA dt. Now, let a particle be located at point P, which is at a position vector r, and the in time delta t, the particle is shifted to the point Q, which is at a distance r plus delta r at time dt. Therefore, the distance of PQ, since it is very small, we consider this as a straight line. So, this distance becomes delta r. Therefore, the area of the triangle, becomes half into r cross del r del t. Now the area swept out by the interval of time del r del t. If we consider the limiting value, del E del T is equal to dA dt. Is equal half into r cross dr dt. Now, in the previous section, we see that r cross v is some constant vector. In this space, r cross v is a constant vector. So, from this, r cross v is the h. So, h by 2. Now, h is a constant vector, so its quantity is constant. Okay, so the aerial velocity of the particle moving under central force is constant. The fourth property of central force is that the central force is conservative force field. Central force is conservative in nature. So the curl value of F will be 0. We are to prove curl value of F is equal to 0. Now, F can be represented, as we discussed in lecture 1, F can be represented as some function of r into r cap. So, curl of f r into r cap is equal. We apply a vector quantity, curl of phi a means grad phi cross a plus phi grad curl of r cap. Now this is 0. So from this, if r cross r cap, according to the property, this is equal to d of fr dr into r cap cross r cap. Now this is zero, so the whole quantity becomes zero. So we see that the curl of F ultimately becomes zero. From this we can say that the central force is a conservative in nature.